Hi, this is a little introduction and demo of a little tool that I've worked on this weekend called ShowMIDI. Over the last few years, I've been like always frustrated when I had to look at streams of MIDI messages and when I had to analyze or debug what is going on. So let's show what the problem is and why I'm frustrated. So I'm opening two solutions here to analyze them. One is MIDI Monitor, which is a very popular Mac tool. And then Receive MIDI is a command line tool that I wrote a few years ago. And let's connect my instrument and play one note. So one note, there you go. There's all these messages. I don't know which note I pressed. It was all the way at the beginning. There's this note on. Let's say I play two notes now. And it's an MPE, so it's on two MIDI channels and everything is interleaved. It becomes very complicated to actually analyze what is going on. And now you can start going through and filtering on messages here. Like I only want certain messages. But in essence, it's always very similar things that you want to do. So actually I want to keep that open. Let's open it up again so that you can see the difference. So let's launch ShowMIDI. It's very bare bones. I basically just started working on it on like 2 days ago. So the idea is MIDI is just a bunch of buckets. You have ports that have MIDI channels, and then you have different types of messages, like a control change message has a number and then values change for that particular number. Channel pressure, it's only channel pressure that changes, and pitch bend, and then notes have poly pressure and a velocity, and those are all sort of compartmentalized concepts. You're usually just interested in what happens in that area and like keep it neatly compartmentalized. So let's connect the instrument here and ShowMIDI like detected that it's there. It resized the window. It's got a limit of number of devices that will automatically show up, and then you can also manually resize the window. Look, let's do that here. So let's put it here and let's do the same thing I just did. I play one note and there you go. So play it again. Now it's on channel 3, on channel 4. So it's MPE, does channel rotation. You can see this is D1, it's velocity 100, and it's got no poly pressure, but it's using channel pressure. And then it's using CC74 for the MPE, third dimension of control. And then if you use pitch bend, you can see the pitch bend appear in the top of it. Now, one of the concepts here is if you stop using something, then it disappears after 2 seconds. So things clear out and it sort of becomes neat and not overwhelming. Everything that you've not used will be gone after a while. So let's now do two notes. And you've seen that the other one disappeared. You saw the note on and then a note off, and then after 2 seconds it's gone. So two notes, I can see exactly what's happening with two notes immediately. Now let's say that I'm doing something here, I'm doing a pitch bend, and I'm like, okay, this is the part that I'm interested in. I can press pause, press the space bar. And now I paused exactly on the state that did something that I was interested in. It's still tracking everything in the background. So let's say like I have this one note that I'm playing now. If I unpause, I go back to that one note. So what if you connect more devices? So let's connect the keyboard, and let's connect Sensel Morph. They're all MPE devices. So they all just showed up in ShowMIDI, and they're all just buckets. Like you've got information going in those buckets, and let's play one note on each. And so, okay, I can clearly evaluate what is going on here. And then if that's what I want, I pause it, and this is the state I'm interested in. So that's it. You quit it, it's gone. You load it up, it's there immediately. There's no nagging dialogues of state you want to save. It's a real-time visualizer for real-time analysis of what is going on with MIDI on your computer. That's it. It's fully open source. You can get it at GitHub. It's written in Juice and C++. So if you've done any type of audio coding, you usually have used Juice. If you want to customize it, just go in and make changes. There's obviously a bunch of additional stuff that can be done. Like the timeout might want to be configurable, or maybe there's like certain ports that you never want to show because it's showing that network session port here all the time. Maybe you do want, when you pause, you want to have a shortcut to save the state to explicitly do that. So there's a bunch of improvements. This is only just the beginning, but I think it's already very useful for this very particular scenario. What is going on when I play MIDI? Woo! Okay, thanks for watching.